And why is that a foreigner is giving money to Ghana when in reality Ghana have all these resources in here at home?
Right.
So today what we did is we opened the Bible to show you it's actually in the Bible, it's actually a curse based on Deuteronomy 28. So what we bring to you is that we're showing you that our people here in Ghana need to repent and start keeping God's laws. There's a reason those things is happening to our people. Today we show you why this thing is happening to our people. Is that a coincidence? That's what we bring today to you guys in Ghana, to our brothers and sisters in Ghana.
And do you find it strange also that within that same situation we are being faced with a lot of pressure with money and other things to accept things like LGBTQI and then the rest?
Absolutely, absolutely. Because just like our brother said earlier, these money they come with a price. Don't think that they're gonna just keep giving money without asking for something back. A couple of years ago when Obama was in power, when Nigeria asked for help with Boko Haram, he actually said, we can help you, but you're going to have to accept it, homosexuality, lesbianism, LGBT communities. So those are the things that come with a price. Yes, eventually you're going to see the same thing here happen in Ghana. Absolutely.
Which is the mark of the beast.
Which is the mark of the beast the Bible is talking about in the book of Revelation.
And why did you link that to the COVID vaccine?
Oh, wow. You want to answer that?
Yeah, definitely. Well, you got to ask yourself something. How many people in Ghana have been affected by COVID? Not many. If you look at the statistics, Africa was the last place to get hit with COVID. It started in Europe, spread to America, and so forth. So why are they trying to bring the vaccination here? You got to ask yourself that. Look at the history of this world when it comes to vaccinations with black people. Okay, we've been experiments. They used our bodies as experiments. So what we're telling you, we're just giving you a warning. Some of you might have to take it to keep your jobs. That's between you and the Lord. We can't make that decision for you. Just keep your eye open. Keep your eye open and stay, perhaps what's called spiritual discernment of the times that we're living in. There's an agreement with anything. If you're receiving money from US through aid, there's something that you're gonna have to give up. There's no way that the so-called white man, the European powers that be, are gonna continue to support you and aid you without something in return. What do they want in return? They want your soul in return.
So after this meeting, what's your expectation from Ghanaians especially?
Our expectations is what God says in Matthew chapter 19, verse 16. He says, if you want eternal life, keep the commandments. As you look through history, many of our forefathers rose up to fight for us, but why did they lose? And it's not just one, it's not just two, it's not just three. It's not just the revolutionaries that you have here on the continent of Africa, it's not the ones that are in the United States, or the ones that rose up in Europe. Wherever we're at, we always failed to come against the European powers. The only person that could take this man down is God in Christ.
That's right.
God in Christ. But he's only gonna do that once we realize who we are and we repent and keep God's commandments. God will fight for you the same way he fought for us in the time of Egypt when he rose up Moses and fought against Pharaoh. He's gonna fight against this Pharaoh in modern day time, also known as the so-called white man.
My last question would also be, how do you relate Africa to being children of Israel or coming from the tribes of Israel?
When you read the various chapters like Zephaniah chapter 3 verse 10, we just read how the dispersed of Israel was scattered throughout beyond the rivers of Ethiopia. When you read the book of Acts chapter 13 and verse 1, you had various Israelites who came from the region of Niger, known as the Niger River today, and also Nigerian River. We had brothers and sisters from Cyrene. You read about that in the Bible as well. Cyrene was a province in Libya. So we were scattered throughout the whole world. But we have remnants of our brothers and sisters right here on the continent today who have been a product of colonization. Now it's time to wake up.
Ghana is a part.
Oh, yes, you were colonized by the British, which I'm sure you know that, Brother Ivan. You were colonized by the British. You were also colonized by the Portuguese and Dutch. Once again, now it's time to wake up.
To scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.